Good afternoon and happy Father's Day. Thank you so much for coming to our farewell concert today. My name is Betty Bowman, and I'm so delighted that we have so many alumni not only participating in our performing groups, but also in the audience. So thank you for coming. An extra special welcome to both our outgoing superintendent, Dr. Rizzi, and our incoming superintendent, Dr. Marcus, who I've just seen in the audience. As an SHS alum, class of 2005, and a member of the Stoughton School's music faculty for the past 10 years, I've spent countless hours in this room, as I know many of you have as well. Like you, I am so thrilled about the new high school being built next door, specifically the beautiful new performance spaces we'll get to use. But part of me is sad to say goodbye to this special space where so much beautiful music and so many wonderful memories have been created. Just over a year ago, I realized that other music alumni might be feeling the same way, and with the help and support of so many people in this room today, the farewell concert was born. Today you will hear performances from a jazz band, concert band, and chorus made up of SHS alumni, ranging from our newest alumni, class of 2019, to alumni who graduated in the early 1970s, back when this auditorium was new and state-of-the-art. And you will also hear performances from current SHS music students whose presence here shows us that no matter what the venue is, the future of our beloved Stoughton music program is strong. Enough talking for now, time for some music. Our first group to perform today will be the alumni chorus.
Be on life. Yeah.
Thank you. While we take a few moments to reset the stage, I'd like to invite forward SHS Music alumni and current town selectmen, Michael Sullivan and Christine Howe, to read a proclamation from our state legislature. And I'd also like to welcome forward State Senator Walter Timmelty, who is here as well.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, thank you for attending the concert. It's a wonderful thing to see so many alumni, families, friends, and so on here today. I did want to share one sort of band memory before I got into more of the broad brush things about being a selectman and the importance of this event. But one memory that stood out to me was, I think I was a sophomore, and we were playing the Lion King suite. And we used to wheel out this cart. I was a percussionist. We used to wheel out the percussion cart that had all the auxiliary equipment in it. And there was a particular part where it required this special drum to play. And we didn't own the drum at the time. And Mr. C said, well, why don't you guys just use the drum cart? And we said, what do you mean? And he said, just hit the drum cart. And so we actually played the part on the drum cart itself. And so looking at the band today and seeing all of the investment that this town has made into the community to support the programs, knowing that many of you who are here today have pursued an education in music or a career in music, really is a testament to show that this isn't just a creative outlet, but really a future for a lot of the youth that attend Stoughton High School. And the many awards and accolades really speak for themselves for that. And if you look out across the parking lot and see the brand new building that's being constructed, it's really a testament to this town's commitment to the arts program and the music program. And I think that's just wonderful that everybody is on board with that. And it's been proven by the town leadership and then every one of you as residents. So I just wanted to say that and appreciate you all being here today.
Well, thank you guys very much for joining with all of us this afternoon and celebrating a few decades of musical excellence here at the Stoughton High School, no, excuse me, the Ron Christensen Performing Arts Center. Congratulations, Ron. Thank you so much to the family, the friends, the supporters of Stoughton Music, to the many past and current members of POPS who are here today. If you guys aren't members of POPS, please consider joining today. I think they're going to have sign-up sheets downstairs. You know, that organization supports countless scholarships, musical lessons, performances at festivals and music shows. So please consider joining. Thank you so much to the alumni that are here today. Over 130 alumni. Yeah. And can we have a round of applause for Betty Bowman for the work that she's put in for this? And most importantly, I want to take a moment to thank the dozen or so past and current musical educators that are here with us today. You guys have spent so many years of your lives, not only teaching students in the Stoughton Public School systems how to play music, but sort of an appreciation and a passion for music as well. So thank you guys so very much for everything that you've done. As all of you are aware, Stoughton has a rich tradition of music in our community. We are home to the oldest music society in North America, the old Stoughton Musical Society, which I believe was founded sometime maybe in the early 1700s, around the same time that this high school was constructed. 1786, thank you very much. A wonderful tradition of music here in our community. Me personally, I am filled with so much nostalgia being here talking to you guys today, standing on this stage where, you know, 15 years ago as a chubby, awkward high school student I used to perform. Now I'm sort of just, I guess, a chubby, still a little awkward selectman, but but so many fantastic memories on this stage and you know, sort of between these walls. And, you know, we've all heard that expression, if walls could talk. Well, I was thinking to myself last night and this morning, you know, think about the stories that we could, that would be shared through songs in this room, in this auditorium. You know, stories told through songs like Birdland and Willow Crest and God Bless the Child and Bridge Over Troubled Waters. Sleigh Ride, where we had our parents sitting out in the auditorium, vigorously shaking their keys at Ron Christensen's command. Just so many wonderful songs that were practiced and rehearsed here in this auditorium and performed, and then performed elsewhere all across the state. You know, at festivals where we would return with sort of a treasure trove of awards and trophies, first place finishes, gold medals, too numerous to count. It truly was a testament to the quality of the education that we provide our students here in the Stoughton Public School System. You know, Stoughton places a strong emphasis on music. We have our kids play in sports to grow their bodies. We teach them math, science to grow their minds, but we teach them music sort of to feed their souls. And that's something that as a community, we take a lot of pride in, and that's something that's going to continue long into the future at the next high school as well. With that being said, I've spoken a little bit longer than I planned on it. Us selectmen usually do that, so I apologize. And I'd like to invite State Senator Walter Timmelty, who's going to present a proclamation from the House of the Legislature, as well as the Senate here in Massachusetts. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Christine. Well, a very happy Father's Day to all our fathers here in the audience, and it's a privilege to be here today. Give here all the dads. It's a privilege to be here today along with Selectwoman Howe and Selectman Sullivan to recognize the farewell concert. And my thanks to the Farewell Concert Planning Committee led by Betty Bauman, and special thanks to Pops, and of course to our performers, our alumni chorus, our alumni jazz band, our alumni concert band, and our Stoughton High School Symphonic Choir and Stoughton High School Symphonic Band. On behalf of Lou Kafka, Representative Lou Kafka, and Representative Bill Galvin, who are there today celebrating with their grandchildren and children Father's Day, it's my privilege to read a resolution offered by both the State Senate and the House of Representatives. We have two, and this is a synthesis of the two. They were both voted on in each branch and are in the records of the House of Reps and the State Senate, honoring this wonderful farewell concert, which is a harbinger of great things to come for this wonderful town. And it states, congratulations to the Stoughton High School Music Program on performing the farewell concert in the Christensen Performing Arts Center at Stoughton High School in concert with the wonderful musical community that is Stoughton High School and its alumni. Whereas the Stoughton High School Music Program, represented by the Symphonic Band in chorus, along with an alumni jazz band, alumni concert band, and alumni chorus, will be performing a farewell concert to Stoughton High School on Sunday, June 26, 2019 in the Christensen Performing Arts Center. And whereas the Stoughton High School Music Program has a long history of musical excellence, which is evident in the numerous awards, citations, and honors that it has earned, and whereas thousands of students have received an outstanding musical education from the Stoughton High School Music Program and have participated in some of the top-performing high school ensembles in the New England region, including the Stoughton High School Marching Band, Jazz Band, Concert Band, Show Choir, Jazz Choir, Winter Percussion, Treble Choir, Symphonic Band, and Winter Guard, and whereas organized in 1972, under the direction of Ben Elkins, the Stoughton High School Jazz Band has received first place finishes at the Berklee High School Jazz Festival three times since 2006, won an International Association of Jazz Education Gold Medal State Finals Award, and has performed at the Edward A. Hatch Memorial Shell in the city of Boston 13 times since 1993, and whereas organized in 1974 under the direction of music director Don LeGros, the Stoughton High School Jazz Choir won an International Association of Jazz Education Gold Medal State Finals Award and has performed at the Edward A. Hatch Memorial Shell in the city of Boston five times since 2007. And whereas the Stoughton High School Marching Band has received a nine Massachusetts Instrumental and Choral Conductors Association Marching Band State Finals Gold Medal Awards since 2001, has been named the New England School Band Association Championship five times since 2000, won the 2016 U.S. Bands Massachusetts State Champions, and received the Marine Corps Esprit de Corps Award, which is given to a single band in New England each year in recognition of the band's team spirit and enthusiasm in performance. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the members of the Massachusetts House of Representatives and State Senate hereby join with the community of Stoughton to congratulate the Stoughton High School Music Program on performing the farewell concert in the Christensen Performing Arts Center at Stoughton High School, and further extend their sincere wishes for all the alumni and students who are performing here today, and continued musical excellence for this great institution that is Stoughton High, and success in the new school building to be opened this fall of 2019. And be it further resolved that a copy of these resolutions be transmitted furthermore by the clerk of both the House and the Senate to John Manger, the K-12 Director of Fine Arts in Stoughton Public Schools. Signed by our Senate President Karen E. Spilker, our Speaker of the House Robert A. DeLeo, Representative William C. Galvin, Representative Louis L. Kafka, and myself, Walter F. Timulty. Congratulations to the town of Stoughton and this wonderful community that is music.
Thank you so much. Up next is the Alumni Jazz Band under the direction of longtime SHS Fine Arts Director, Mr. Ron Christensen. When people started to register for this concert many months ago, the number one question I was asked was, will Mr. C be there? The answer is yes, and I know that we are all delighted to hear from Mr. C and the Alumni Jazz Band.
Thank you. several soloists. I never should have started to announce because I don't know if I can remember everybody. But we started out with our magnificent percussion section. Greg Goldberg, Chris Small, Barry Silver, Rob Gold, and Bill King. Eric Mad Dog Converse.
Thank you. We have almost 130 alumni performing with us today, and I know that we have several more in the audience. So as we clear the stage and get ready for the alumni concert band, let's take a moment to acknowledge your presence. If you attended Stoughton High School, please stand up and take a bow. Thank you. And of course, none of us would be here today without our devoted and beloved music teachers. So would all Stoughton Public Schools music teachers, past and present, please stand so we can acknowledge and thank you for your years of commitment to the program. We have a few other VIPs in the house today. I would like to acknowledge Mrs. Ruth LeGros and her family. Ruth is wife of Don LeGros, longtime department head here in Stoughton, and we are so happy to have his family represented today. So thank you, Ruth. And another distinguished alum I would like to acknowledge is Mr. Joe DeVito, a local hero, World War II veteran, and a graduate of Stoughton High School 75 years ago. So, Mr. DeVito. I know that we already acknowledged that today is Father's Day, but I want to make just two special Father's Day shout-outs. First of all, to Mr. John Manch, who's celebrating not only his first Father's Day, but also his wedding anniversary today. So thanks. Thanks to the whole Manch family for allowing him to be here today. And I have to shout out my own dad, who's not only celebrating Father's Day, but also his birthday. So happy birthday, Dad. And in just a moment, we will be back with the Alumni Concert Band under the direction of Alana Lawrence. much. At this point, we will take a brief intermission. Pops will have Stoughton Spiritware available for purchase in the lobby where you came in, and there are several relics from the high school up for silent auction in the B-second hallway just outside these doors. The auction goes until 5:30. See you back in 15 minutes. Welcome back. You have made it just in time for a walk down memory lane. Thanks to everybody who contributed pictures and video footage, to Kevin Bechet for digitizing some of the older video footage, and to Dan Block for putting this whole wonderful montage together. But before we watch it, I would like to take care of my thank yous for the afternoon. Thank you to everybody who participated in the concert today, especially to our alumni performers for a beautiful afternoon of music and memories. Thank you to my fellow conductors, Alana, Mr. C, Dan, and Anne, for your preparation and commitment to this concert. Thank you to Pops for the wonderful reception we'll enjoy after the concert, as well as for helping in so many other ways behind the scenes. Thank you to the SPS administration and music faculty for supporting this project since the very beginning. And most importantly, thank you to my planning committee for their time and effort over the last year and all that they have done to make today possible. Planning committee, would you please stand? Thank you so much. And now, time for our montage of memories.
Welcome to this meeting that concerns the student musicians of the Stoughton Public Schools Music Department. These students comprise an area of our school program of which we are very proud. Music is an educational process, and these students are learning the skills and meaning of music in an active learning environment. In addition to being involved educationally, this experience is fun. We'll be right back. Since the early 1980s, the department has maintained a consistent tradition of winning and excelling in all of its musical endeavors. Gold and silver winning vocal and instrumental groups have become the norm. All you need to do is to look through the awards cases or in the music room itself, and you can follow a proud history of accomplishment. We don't measure ourselves to just the adjoining towns of the Hockomock League, but are constantly competitive with all of the Lexingtons, Norwoods, and Brooklines that we encounter in our travels. We don't use competition as a means unto itself, but rather as a tool to measure our own growth or need for improvement. We stress the quality of what we do and the development of the skills and understanding needed to reach our goals. While the rewards are nice, we value the process, the discipline and hard work necessary to reach our goals.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me.
The roughly 4,000 students in the school system, 3,100 are involved in music education, whether it's performing groups or general music classes. In bands and choruses alone, from grades 4 through 12, there are over 2,000. That's one of every two children who sing in a chorus or play in a band.
Reach out my hand to you. I'll have faith in all you do.
get involved so that all areas of our town will continue to flourish and to grow. If you have questions or wish to speak to someone further about this presentation, please contact one of the Parents and Performing Students representatives, or POPS, or you can contact me, Ronald R. Christensen, Director of Fine Arts, Stoughton Public Schools. Thank you so much for taking the time to be with us during this presentation. Thank you.
Thank you. That was awesome. Wow. Thank you, Mr. Black. This year's SHS Symphonic Band was fortunate enough to commission a new work by renowned composer James Stevenson based on our town's musical history. I'll read you part of a note from the composer himself. In researching the area of Stoughton, Massachusetts and its important aspects, I was directed to the fact that Stoughton houses the longest standing musical society in the country. It is called, appropriately, the Old Stoughton Musical Society. As it is always my intention to write music that is directly related to the people, institutions for whom it is being written, I was particularly drawn to this society and furthermore to the history of it. It was formed in 1786, making it, of course, almost as old as our very country. What struck me at first was the reason for its existence. It seemed that prior to its formation, the music of the area had gone completely awry in terms of study and in terms of the level of performance. That in the previous 17th and 18th centuries, the performance of music had become so knowingly bad, most obviously due to a lack of formalized teaching, that it had become almost a point of pride to sing music loudly and badly. The Old Stoughton Musical Society set out to right this wrong with bylaws, meetings, performances, and composers. One of these such composers was William Billings. In looking through his music, I came upon a rather humorous little ditty entitled Modern Music. It is a choral work that almost employs as much wordplay and musical puns as I myself have been known to write on occasion. To be honest, I was a little stunned by such a thing having been written back in 1790. I couldn't avoid doing something with it. Therefore, many of the tunes woven through my old modern music are derived from that of Mr. Billings. The overall tone is that of celebration, because we are celebrating Stoughton, its music, its people, its heritage. The SHS Symphonic Choir will sing William Billings' original piece, Modern Music, and then the SHS Symphonic Band will present the world premiere of James Stevenson's new work, Old Modern Music. Enjoy.
Thank you. Good afternoon. While the Symphonic Choir is moving, and some of them are coming up to join the Symphonic Band now, I just have a couple of quick remarks for you. My name is John Mange, by the way. I'm the Finance Director. First of all, thank you to Betty Bowman, who masterminded this entire thing. Betty did an incredible job. This whole thing came together because it was her idea, her conception. She brought it here, and it's really beautiful to see what has happened. I want to thank all of the very distinguished alumni and faculty who are present today. I have to tell you, it is so inspiring to our current music faculty as well as our current students to see what an amazing community of Stoughton-trained music makers exists outside of these walls. This is very unusual, and you need to know, and most people in this room do, and that's why you're here, how precious this is. Such a depth of history of people who learned and performed on this stage, people for whom these experiences were so transformative that they are still coming back to celebrate this program after so many years. We are very grateful for the many alumni, teachers, parents, and students who cherish this music community. It is unique, and it requires constant and unflagging stewardship, but it sets the town of Stoughton apart, and it makes this community a truly special place. Please enjoy this original commissioned work by Jim Stevenson. It was written for you, Stoughton, and it is a celebration of all of the music makers who have gone through this very fine program. Enjoy.
much for coming and for all you've done to support music in our schools over the past several decades. I am thrilled to watch our department continue to flourish in its new home next year. I remind you that the silent auction is going on until 5:30, so you've got a few more minutes. And if you win and you are still here at that point, you are welcome to take your item home today. If you leave before then, you'll get a call later this week to pick up your item before they tear the building down. Also, if you are an alum who performed today, we have a party favor for you. If you'd like, you may take home a music stand, just not one of the newer looking ones. Please join us downstairs for a pop-sponsored reception. And again, happy Father's Day and farewell.